As of October 5th of 2025, there are currently 43 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, which produced a new eruption this week, is Russia's glacier-covered Kronotsky stratovolcano. Or did it? You see, there's a major problem. On October 4th, at about 10 a.m. local time in Kamchatka, the Russian equivalent of the U.S. Geological Survey reported that a vent on Kronotsky explosively erupted, marking its first eruption since 1923. This eruption seemingly produced no lava, indicating a purely phreatic origin, and created a large eruption plume that drifted to the east. Only one problem. I can't find any concrete visual evidence whatsoever that this volcano erupted in the scope that was claimed. It shows no thermal signatures, no ash or runoff from melted glacial ice on its slopes, and the only nearby eruption plume is from ongoing strong activity at the Krasheninnikov volcano to the south. Even worse, the few videos I've seen being shared around of its apparent eruption are all AI-generated footage. Now, some unproven speculation. In my opinion, I suspect that a mistake was made, possibly by an automated sensor, that mistook Krasheninnikov's ongoing eruption plume as originating from Kronotsky. But what I just said is unproven, it is only my opinion, and maybe the simplest explanation is an eruption did occur from Kronotsky after all, and I alone am the one who is wrong. With that being said, here are the rest of this week's top volcano-related news stories. In the Philippines, the Taal volcano erupted anew, even ejecting lava fragments after a highly damaging magnitude 6.9 earthquake. Meanwhile, in Chile, after months of unrest, the Planchón-Peteroa volcano erupted anew, creating a small plume of ash that drifted to the east. And, in what is this week's top story, Hawaii's Kilauea volcano produced its most spectacular eruptive episode since 2018. What do I mean by this? Simple, a sustained multi-hours-long lava fountain that if it had hypothetically been transported to New York City would have reached near the top of the modern skyline. Specifically, involving 400-meter or 1,312-foot high lava fountains from Kilauea's summit caldera. Its 34th eruptive episode since December 23rd of last year began just before midnight on September 30th. The north vent soon was continuously erupting molten rock at a high rate, which created an ever-growing lava fountain that grew taller and taller into the earliest morning hours of October 1st. Then, at 2 a.m., the southern vent erupted, creating two towering lava fountains, which within 30 minutes reached their peak height. By the time this eruptive episode ended at 7:03 a.m., it had erupted a total of 9.2 million cubic meters of lava. This means it had the highest lava fusion rate across any of the eruptive episodes, totaling an average of about 350 cubic meters per second. Now, the 35th episode, in my opinion, is most likely to begin sometime between October 11th and October 17th. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, a destructive magnitude 6.9 earthquake struck offshore of Cebu Island at 9:59 p.m. local time on September 30th, causing widespread damage. Then, about 4 hours later, the Taal volcano on the island of Luzon erupted for its first time since September 12th. A 5-minute-long phreatic eruption occurred first, followed by a 15-minute-long phreatomagmatic eruption which ejected visible incandescent bombs of lava. This was completely confined harmlessly to Taal's central island, but its proximity and time to that major earthquake begs the question. Was this eruption caused by the distant earthquake? Probably not. The Taal volcano's magma chamber did not experience strong enough shaking to trigger an eruption, only experiencing an MMI shaking intensity of 2 when at least a 5 was needed to possibly cause this. And in Chile, after several months of increasing seismic activity, the Planchón-Peteroa volcano finally erupted on October 3rd. This created a weak, low-level ash plume, presumably from a phreatic eruption not involving any magma from the southwesternmost of its summit craters. This weak ash plume continued for multiple hours thereafter, although no further eruptive activity has occurred since. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on October 4th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Anita Joplin, for supporting my work.